Okay, so I think it's time to go do some heart piece hunting. But before that, I think we can collect some more golden bugs from around Kakariko Village. The first one is in the graveyard, and then another one I think is in one of the buildings. Pretty sure that's a 50 rupee chest, so we probably won't even be able to take it. Yep. But it won't fit in your wallet. Some birds and it rains rupees on us, apparently. There's one of the bugs. I got a male ant. Like I said, the female ant should be somewhere in one of the buildings in town. Oh, so Talo's way up there, huh? Is it this building? Ah, there you are. Okay, so we have both the male and female ant. Two more bugs for the collection. I think there's like 24 in all. Pretty much all of them have a set, like a male and female to find. So we have 6 right now. But a third of the way of them. A third of the way with them done. Now, one of the first things we need to do is I think Barnes should be selling bombs and bomb bags at the moment. So let's buy them if they're available. Oh. Got a special offer going right now, my bomb bag premium kit, which comes with bag and bombs for 120 rupees. I'll take it. And you can combine bombs with arrows to make bomb arrows when you need ranged explosives. Thank you, Barnes. Now this game is actually a little bit unique in that you can buy different types of bomb. I think you get 3 bomb bags total. No wait, no, that's not right. There are 3 different types of bombs you can get. I'm not quite sure now. I know you can hold different types of bombs at some point, but you need different bags. And you can upgrade them later so that I think they can hold a maximum of 99, if I'm not mistaken. Anyway, let's head up here. Now, Renato mentioned that Tala was up here on the watchtower, so we're gonna have to talk to him. Hey, Agora. Don't worry about it. You had your own problems to deal with. Okay, I'll climb on. Send me up, dude. Thank you. Hey there, Tala. How are you now? I could show you how to use one, yes. Okay. Yes, apparently. Malo sure is a weird one. I can sure try. Gotcha. Try to hit this pole. Okay, now that may be a little bit of a challenge. Oh, but I nailed it first try. Yay! Not bad. That was cool. Just a little. Thank you, Malo. Now, I think he has something new for us in his shop. Let's take a look. Yes, the Hawkeye. This eyewear allows you to see distant objects as if with the eyes of a hawk. This handy scope excels at zooming in on distant objects. Combine it with the hero's bow, and you can zoom in on distant objects and blah 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 blah. Alright, alright, jeez, I just bought from you. So now if we combine the Hawkeye with the hero's bow, it acts as a sniper scope, which is pretty cool. We don't need it at the moment, though. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and make bomb arrows, and we're gonna blow up that rock that's over there. And look, another heart piece. Not quite close enough yet. There we go. Just one more, then we get another heart container. Let's go ahead and blow up that rock there. And I think we can get yet another heart piece here in town. I really can't wait until I upgrade my wallet. That way I don't have to keep putting rupees back. Alright. That's quite a few heart pieces we found just in this little area. Now, notice that rock down there. We can actually blow up rocks later on in the game, but at this point, we just can't. Once new bomb types become available, we'll be able to, though. Okay, I think we're done in Kakariko at the moment. So let's head to Hyrule Field. No. Hey there, postman. Oh, two letters for us. That's neat. Thank you for your patronage. Enjoy the power of our bombs. Not only can you place and throw our bombs, but they can be combined with the bow by going to the item screen and using R to create bomb arrows. Try it today. Well, I already have, but... New Sundries Shop in Kakariko. If you haven't already been by the look, I have an item that isn't available anywhere else. Come by before someone else snatches it. And please, no window shoppers. Now, I think he's just talking about the hot guy there, but we already got it. So now that we have bombs, we can blow open this cave here. Buzz off, bird brain. Okay, we're gonna need our lantern in here. That thing that just dropped from the ceiling was actually a yellow choo-choo. And if we had actually scooped it up, we could have used it as another source of fuel for the lantern. Believe it or not. Let's head back, and then head this way. Head this way, I guess. Sure are a lot of bats in this cave. I guess that makes sense. It is a cave, after all. Now that thing there, that is actually a Poe spirit. But it's invisible to us, and there's nothing we can do to hurt it at the moment. Now, you might remember the Gold Skulltula quest from Ocarina of Time and, to a lesser extent, Majora's Mask. In this game, I believe there are 60 Po Souls that you can collect, but only the wolf form can see them. So that's not a quest that we can tackle It's not a quest we can tackle until later in the game. The rewards for the collecting the pole souls in this game isn't that great either. I think if you get 20, you get another empty bottle, and then at 60 you get, well, rupees. Just like the for collecting all 100 gold skull tools in Ocarina of Time, you got 200 rupees. Whoop-de-doo. Also, yes, that was yet another heart piece for our collection. Go me. There's just one more route that we can explore, then we can just leave this place. Oh, never mind, there's not really anything interesting here either. Well, I got some arrows, so it wasn't a complete waste. Okay, let's get out of here. Next on my checklist, I believe we need to be returning to Orden Village. I think we can get some more rubies up here on the hill. Yep, I thought so. Now, is there anything under this rock? Okay, now let's make our way to Orden Village. Yeah. Okay, so the reason I came back to Ordin Village is that we should be able to play the goat herding minigame again. And I think if we do it under a certain amount of time, we should be able to get yet another heart piece. There you are, Fado. Sure thing. Five more to go. Oops, that's not a goat. Alright, thank you, Fado. No problem, dude. So I guess the time limit for that is getting all the goats in 3 minutes? It's either that or 2 minutes and 30 seconds. I'm not sure which. It's not too difficult, though. Okay, so let's make our way back to Kakariko now. Blow up that rock there, but I don't think there's much point to it at the moment. There is a heart piece behind that rock somewhere, but we don't have the... I think we need another tool or something, or be able to change it to wolf before we're able to do it. So we'll just leave that there. Okay, path cleared. Now we can reach a new section of Hyrule. Well, technically we've been here once, but that was when we were chasing King Golden. I see the gold buck. Nope, nope, don't dash it off. Male grasshopper. Alright, so I'm gonna need a bow and arrow combo. Because we're gonna have another rock that we have to pull up. So it's gonna be nighttime now. There's the rock that we have to get. Now we can jump across. And ta-da! We made it to another treasure chest. We are sure collecting a lot of heart pieces. We must have found like close to 10. Just around here. Okay, maybe not 10, but we did find a lot. Alright, now there are actually two sets of bugs in this area of the field, I think. Another one's around here somewhere. I thought this would be easier to find at nighttime. There it is, I think. Okay, so that's two grasshoppers accounted for. Is there another set of bugs that I can get around here? Because I think there is. There's one. Phasmid. And there's the other one. And the female phasmid. Yay! Okay, so that's 10 of the 24 golden bugs collected. Only 14. We're almost halfway done with them, believe it or not. Only 14 more left to go. Alright guys, so this is would probably be a good stopping point, because from here on out we're going to be heading, well, I think through Hyrule Castle next, maybe? I know we got to go through another Twilight section, and then we'll be making our way towards the third dungeon of the game. But that'll be for next time, so see you then, guys.